Hello student, welcome to my class of computer science for class 11. Today student, we are going to write a program to find out or to check whether the given number by user is palindrome or not. So first of all, we have to understand what is palindrome number student. Palindrome number are actually those number student whose reverse value same as its original value. For example, if I'm going to talk about 1 to 1 is equivalent to definitely again 1 to 1, this is palindrome number. Okay, so here 111 is also considered as a palindrome number because its reverse will be definitely same, but in the term of 12 will not be the same as 12. Okay, so it will not be a palindrome number. So what I'm going to do student, I'm going to open a new particular script file. Okay, so here I have opened this one program. Okay, so in this I will, as you know, I will use the comment for that, a simple code, that is a comment, a program for palindrome number. Okay, now after that I will design original number, that is OR number, as a variable, because original number should be a meaningful. Okay, that's why OR number I have taken here. So I will say there raw input, because I'm using Python 2.7 version, that's why I will use raw input, otherwise you can directly use input. So please enter a number. Okay, simply I will say, and then after that I will try to check exception handling, whether the number is number or not. For example, if user giving the number like ABC, so that time my program should catch it and then give the particular answer to the user. I am to say exception. So in a part of exception handling, I will use here exception handling part. Then after that I will say try, because try catch block, I am say try except block will help me how to do that. So well equals to, first of all I will put the sensitive code here. So within typecast I will say that whether original number will be typecast or not. If it is not, then it will say simply a message, that is except. Okay, what thing, value error. Then after that I will say simply a message, this is not a valid number. Okay, and then after that finally I will print a message that will say user, the process is completed, by separate by slash n, that will I want to see the next in next line, whatever the case. Okay, now I will just run this particular program. I will save this particular file name with p2. Now you can see this will work. So now you can see there is no exception till now. Suppose that if I'll enter here p0 whatever, so that time will show you answer, that is this is not a valid number. So that is the effect of exception handling student. Okay, so now you can see student what is going on. If I'm going to just run it, now you can see if I'm going to enter any number, that will easily accept the value and that will say at last exception handling process is completed, because finally block will show you the information, this particular try catch and exception handling process is completed or not. After that it will show you, okay, even the program is successfully working or not. To finally block will definitely execute always. Okay, and now what I will do to check the particular this one thing, palindrome number, as I teach you the palindrome number are reversible number, okay, its own reversible number same as it is. So what I'm going to do, student, I will just do this one thing, student. I will just use if condition here, and then after that I will check original number, that is OR number, okay, that will definitely double equals to, okay, it's str format. Whose str format? Because I'm going to type cast the str of val, okay, that is value, and then after that I will do the slicing mechanism. As you know, in a string method we have understand what is slicing method, okay. So according to this slicing index 0 till then end minus 1 and minus 1 and step by step minus 1, okay, and then after that I will say if it is correct, I am to say if it the reverse element is same like this, it will show you simply print a message, yes, this is palindrome number, okay. Otherwise we can say that in else part, sorry, okay, within print, sorry, this is not a palindrome number. Okay, now we are going to just run it, and now we are going to check it. So first of all I will put 1, definitely 1 will be palindrome number of 1 again. So I will show you the next output in fresh copy, 99, so it is also palindrome number because 99 just opposite to 99 again. And now suppose that 78, this is a not a palindrome number, you can see this is not a palindrome number because 78 reverse will be 87. So student, we have got how to find out the palindrome number of given input and value that is given by user. So simply you have to just type this particular code, okay, and then you can see if the number is just opposite to reversible number of original number is termed as palindrome number, okay. So student, I will teach you new thing also, student. If you don't want to use a try catch block, I am to say exception handling, we can directly do one thing, student, we can directly use this particular number in a string format. For example, we can say that we will directly typecast in str first, okay. I will show in a comment also. So str first, whatever the input has come here, input statement, I will show you in by dash, this all input inside this, and then after that within this particular val comparison, okay, what we are going to do, student, we will do only one thing, we will do str, suppose that here str value, we can say that str val equals to or val or or number, that is I have already used, okay, and then after that in this particular condition I definitely use again the slicing mechanism, that will be definitely or number definitely equals to, that is str, okay, if it is comment, because I want to show it in a comment because this will never affect my program. So str and then after that value, okay, because here will be considered as value, and then it's a slicing mechanism, so result will be same without any exception handling. So student, this is another way you can make the another one program for the same. You can just ask to user to input a number in OR number, which is typecast by string, okay, not by integer, okay, and then after that you will directly check OR number to str number, okay, and then you can slice it and you can see the output will come. So student, I hope you have understand this particular how to get the palindrome number program easily, okay. Till then student, thank you and have a nice day.